Hey guys, this is Amar Hissal and I am your Gani buddy for today.
So in this session, we will design and assemble the press tool assembly. This is the press tool assembly. This is the explored view of press tool. This is the figure showing bottom plate and this is the dimension and view of the top plate with dimension. And this is the dimension and view of the guide pillar and guide bolts. So we have to design in the CATIA software. So open CATIA software. Go to start, mechanical design, part design. So in the part name, we have to give the part name as the bottom plate. So here we will design first bottom plate. Okay, so click OK. Now this is the figure showing the bottom plate and with dimension. So we have to put this dimension in the CATIA software. So we have to first draw the rectangle of the 250 and 150 length. So go to XY plane, go to sketcher section, go to the tool center rectangle, select the origin as a center, draw rectangle in any dimension. So select this line, go to constraint tool and give dimension to this line as 250 because this line is 250. Okay, now select this vertical line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as this vertical dimension 150, so 150, press OK. So now zoom out. We have to make here hole, so of the dimension 50, so and this should be 150 distance from this line and 50 distance from the this line. So go to circle, draw a circle at this place, you know, from this is from the center of the circle. So draw in any dimension, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 50. Now this dimension from this line is 50. So select the center of this circle. Now select this line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 50. So this circle center is 50 millimeter from this horizontal line. Now we have to draw this hole of the 25 diameter and this is from 30 millimeter this line. So go to circle, draw a circle, select this circle, go to constraint tool, this diameter is 25, so put here 25 mm, press OK. Select the center of this circle, select this line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as this is from 30 mm, so and this is vertically 30 mm and horizontally also 30, put 30 mm. Okay, so again select this circle, select this line and go to the constraint tool, two dimension as 30. So this circle is horizontally and vertically 30 mm from the line. Now we have to draw three more circle like this. So here we will do draw imaginary line vertically from the center of this rectangle. So draw imaginary line, select this circle, go to mirror tool, select the imaginary line. So now you can see that our second circle is there. So delete this first imaginary line. Now we have to draw more two circles. So again go to imaginary line, draw imaginary line horizontally from the center of the circle, select this two circle. Now go to mirror tool, select the imaginary line. So our two circle are made directly, you can see here. Okay, now we will exit the workbench here, exit the workbench, go to the pad section and we will put here pad length as this length is given 30 mm. So here we will put 30, press OK. So we can see that our bottom plate is ready. Now again we have to make a new part here, so we can zoom out. So you can see here our bottom plate is ready. Now we will go to mechanical design, part design, and we will here put the part name as, now we will design here top plate. Okay, so this is the dimension and we have the top plate here, so we will put the part name as top plate and press OK. Now we will here select XY plane, go to the sketcher section, we have to draw a rectangle of 250 and 150 dimension. So go to center rectangles tool, center rectangle, select the origin as a center, draw rectangle in any dimension, select this horizontal line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 250 here, 250, press OK. Now select this vertical line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as this vertical dimension are 150, press OK. Now exit, zoom out. So in the we have to draw a four circle here. Okay, so first we will draw a circle here of the diameter 40. So select the circle tool, draw a circle here in the corner in any dimension, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 40 mm, select. So this circle is also 30 mm and 30 mm from horizontal and vertical. So select the center of this circle, select this line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 30 mm, put 30 here. Then this is also vertically 30 mm from this line. So select the center of this circle, this line, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 30 mm. So now we have to draw three more circle here as we have done. So you can see here, so this is from, so we again go to imaginary line, draw imaginary line vertically from the center of the rectangle, select this circle, go to mirror tool, select the imaginary line. So our circle, second circle is actually drawn. So again go to imaginary line, draw imaginary line horizontally from the center of this rectangle, select this now two circle, go to mirror tool and select the imaginary. So our four circle are made here, delete this imaginary line. So you can see that our four circle are made here. So you can see that this dimension and this dimension constant tool are 90 as it's seen here. So we don't have to give dimension, it's are automatically dimensioned. So here you can see that 190. Okay, so here we exit the workbench, go to pad section, and we have to give pad length here as 30. This is shown here, so we will go to pad length 30. Press OK. Okay, so we have to now make here a pad of a 50 mm circle and give pad length 90. So we will select this surface, go to sketcher section. Now we have to draw a circle first here, and this is from 125 dimension from this line. So go to circle tool, draw a circle from the center of this line, go to constraint, give dimension as 50 here given. So give dimension 50, press OK. Now select the center of this tool, select the center of this tool, this circle and this line, give dimension as the dimension are given from this 100. So we'll put here 100, press OK. Now our circle is drawn at this place. Now, so you can see here. Now we will exit our range, go to pad section. Now we have this pad length is given as 90 mm. Okay, so here we will put 90, press OK. So you can see our zoom out, you can see our top plate is ready. We can see here the dimension and top plate. Now we have to design the guide pillar and guide post. So we'll go to the mechanical design part design. Here we will first design guide pillar. So we'll put enter the name, part name as guide pillar here. Press OK. So select XY plane, go to sketcher section. So this is the guide pillar here, given dimension 200 mm and the diameter is 25. So here first we'll draw a circle here, draw a circle in any dimension, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 25 mm, press OK. Here we will exit the workbench, go to pad tool, give pad length. Here the pad length is given 200 mm, so here we will put 200, press OK. So light pillar is ready, it will zoom out. Now we have to chamfer it, so we will first zoom in. So we have to select this surface, go to chamfer tool. For the chamfer we have given the chamfer length as 2 mm and angle is given 45. So here we will put chamfer length 2, angle is already 45, press OK. So our right pillar chamfer from one side. Now to so select this side again. For this selection zoom in, select this surface, go to chamfer tool, give chamfer length as 2 and angle 45, press OK, zoom out. So our guide pillar is ready. Now we will design again, go to mechanical design, part design. So here we have to design guide bush here. Okay, so put the guide bush and part name as guide bush, press OK. So here we have to design the guide bush here. So this is the dimension of the guide bush are given. So here we will go to XY plane, go to sketcher section. Now here we will select a circle tool, say draw a circle, again draw a circle. The first circle diameter is 40, so go select this circle, go to constraint tool, give dimension as 40 mm. Select the second circle, the dimension is 25, so give constraint as 25, press OK. Now exit the workbench, go to the pad tool. Here we have to put the pad length as given is 60 mm, so here we will put 60, press OK. Now we have to chamfer it. Our guide bush is ready, but we have to chamfer it. So the chamfer length is given 2 and the angle is given 45. Select this surface, go to chamfer tool. Here put chamfer length 2, angle is already 45, press OK. So it chamfered from one side. Select this surface, go to chamfer tool again, chamfer length 2, angle 45, chamfered from both sides. OK, so our guide bush is ready. And see our light bush is ready. So now we have to assemble. Go to mechanical design, assembly design, select the assembly design. Now we have to assemble the all part. Go to existing component command, select the product, select the bottom plate, press OK. So our bottom plate is here. Now we will adjust it first, press OK. So select the isometric view, go to the existing component with position and command, select product. Here we will select now guide pillar, search guide pillar. Okay, now our guide pillar is here. Okay, so here we will select the coincident constraint tool, select the axis of this pillar and the axis of this. Okay, so go to the offset constraint. Here we will select this surface and zoom in for selecting this surface. So select this surface and here we will put offset as 0. Okay, so press OK. Now we will zoom out and press update. So you can see our first guide pillar is at its position. Okay, so now we have to make three areas. Okay, so go to guide pillar, double click on guide pillar, go to rectangular patterns. Okay, so here put number of instant to spacing 190. Go to the second direction, here number of instruction 2, spacing should be 90, put 90. Okay. You can see that the spacing is 90 and 190. Okay, so here go to the reference selection, select this surface, go to reverse, you can see here and press OK. So our four guide pillar are at its position. You can see our full guide pillar at position. Now we have to go to double click on the product, go to existing component with positioning command, go to the top plate, select the top plate, open. Now we will first adjust the top plate here like this, press OK. Go to the manipulation tool for adjusting it. Sir, first we will minus this, go to the manipulation tool, first we will rotate like this, so try to adjust it, so this one, adjust it, so okay, it is adjust. Go to the isometric view, okay, press OK. So here we will put here, press OK. Now we will go to the coincident constraint tool, select the axis of this guide pillar and axis of this circle. Okay, now we will again go to the coincident circle, select this axis, select this axis, select update. Okay, now we will go to manipulation tool here, select the z axis here. Okay, now we have to bring here up. Okay, so plus okay. Now we have to recall the boost, so go to product, search boost here, guide boost, press OK. So first of all adjust the boost from here, select the boost and adjust here. Okay, press OK. Now go to the manipulation tool, select the boost and adjust here, press OK. So first we will go to the coincident constraint command, select the axis of this boost, select this axis, press OK. Now we will go to the offset constraint command, select the surface. Okay, so first we will zoom in for the selection of this surface. So zoom in as you want. So now select this surface and here we will put offset at 0, press OK. We will zoom out. Now press select the update. So select the update. So our first boost is at its position. Okay, so now we have to make the four bush like this for the position. Now we will go to the guide bush. Here, go to guide bush, double click on guide bush, go to the rectangular pattern command, press OK. Here we will put number of instead 2, again we will put spacing 190, go to second direction, number of instead 2, spacing should be 90 here, and reference element select this surface, go to reverse, first direction, go to reverse. Now you can see that in the preview section you can see our full array, and press OK. So our four bush are at its position. Okay, so here we will minus it, you can see. Now we will go to the first, go to manipulation tool here, go to product, double click on product, go to manipulation tool, select the z-axis, and we will select on the top plate. Here we will we'll put down, press OK, and we will go to update. So we will select update. Now you can see our press tool assembly is ready. Here you can see in any direction. So it is at, is in the PDF. You can see our press tool assembly is here ready. So our designing and assembly of the press tool is completed here. So we will hide the constraint. So like, share and subscribe.